because I want my component to lay perfectly flat. Mm-hmm. And with the solder iron, I can't heat both places at the same time. Mm-hmm. So, take the component, and my nice warm, my puddle of solder here, and I heat that up again. So I put the solder iron in, and I put the component into the one nice warm puddle. And let take the solder iron out, still holding the component. Then I can let the component go. Then what I do, I revisit it, I put my thingy
supplier,
yep, on top, push a little bit on it, not like pushing down on it, but just leaning on it a little bit, and I reheat the solder. That way I make sure that it's perfectly flat. Mm-hmm. Because solder is not a conductor. It's a bit of glue, but it's not meant to conduct electricity. It does conduct electricity, the tin, but it's better if you have the component actually sitting on the copper. But the bulk of the electronics, the electrons are going through that connection. This is just to fill the gap. It's not, if it's high up, it's not supposed to bridge things. You can use it that way, but it's not supposed to. It's better to have it all flat on the surface. Especially when you get around your crystal, it's important to get everything nice and flat. Okay, then we can go around to the other side, and what we do is, because remember we can't put some solder on here and then glue it on, you also can't paint with solder. So if you cut it on one side, you can't drag it over to the other side. That doesn't work that way. Let's work out this one here. So we do is put the solder iron in the corner between the pad and the component, and then I add solder right into that corner there. So, right there. That was a bit enthusiastic.
Really good boy.
Okay. So, what we have now is on the board here, we've got solder on. Mm-hmm. One side, but solder on the other side. Now sometimes, if you've got a bigger component, sometimes it's good to revisit your old solder joint. Mm. If it's not nice and shiny. See this solder joint? Both of them are nice and shiny. Mm-hmm. If they're not nice and shiny, you need to revisit them, heat them up again, and add a little bit more solder. That will make it shiny. If you've got too much solder, you need to use the solder braid to take the solder away again. Add a bit of fresh solder.
So what's the advantage of using flux paste?
Okay, flux paste will help the...